gonna snow. By now I should be used to the cold. Mid-February shouldn't be so scary. It was only December. I still remember the presents, the tree.
My name is Bill Appleberry, and I'm a producer and mixer, and I've had the fortunate opportunity to work with such bands as Stone Temple Pilots, Puddle of Mud, The Wallflowers. Currently, we are in a building called The Schoolhouse on the Jim Henson lot, and this room is called The Playground. And we have put this room together to accommodate a current project that we have been on called The Voice on NBC. So because of the high volume of songs that The Voice requires, It has forced me to evolve from mixing analog SSL type mixes in the past to mixing more out of the box and doing digital mixes. Within the last year, we've done close to 400 songs. So this room was designed specifically to keep that in mind, to do high quality record quality mixes in a digital environment. And Slate products have been a huge part of making that possible for us. I was introduced to the Slate products 2 years ago when FGX came out, and I fell in love with it. And FGX to me allowed me to kind of pre-master my mixes without coloring them. So at this point of the game, in these voice mixes, we actually mix through FGX before it hits mastering. So we're really excited about that product. And through that, VTM had come out, and we were introduced to that through Jay Baumgartner at NRG, and fell in love with that as well. So we incorporated that into our mixes and Trigger at the same time. Trigger, although our drum sounds are pretty high quality, we recorded Ocean in Burbank, and we put a lot of time into our drum sounds. Trigger just kind of helps kind of take everything up to the next level. And because we're doing so many songs at so many different styles of music, everything from country to rock to pop to dance, to whatever, we have to have the ability to change colors in the mixing stage quickly. So that's what we've chosen to do, and the Slate products have been absolutely great for that and very consistent. So I'll walk you through what we're doing here. So I put a session up from The Voice. This is something that we've already had completed, but I wanted to make an example of how we use Slate products. This is an artist called Cassidy Pope, and the song's called Over You. And we're very proud of this track. It went to number one on the iTunes Top 200 charts. And just to give you a quick overview of how I use Slate products in my mixes, starting with VTM, I'm digging into this thing more and more on every song that I do. And at the moment, I choose to use this tape emulator on the overheads. I use it on the rooms. I use it on the vocals, actually, and it's a big part of my backup vocal chain. I find that I could saturate different vocals differently to create this kind of thing with the backup vocals, so they poke out into different spots where I'd like them to poke out. I also choose to use, at this point of the game, getting into some of the presets, or some of the settings. I tend to put my vocals on 15 nips, mostly because I'm trying to bring the 80s back. And my bias is always set to low. And that kind of, for me, kind of contours the top end a little bit, so I can control the top end with EQ a little bit on the back end. And that seems to work out well. And then I'll adjust my input level to get it to where it's just kind of almost getting into the red a little bit, to where you can feel it kind of pop a little bit. I also, on the overheads, I'll set those to a different setting, and I'll put those on 30. My bias again is set to low on these, only because I, you know, know, I tend to make these mixes a little bit brighter on the back end, so I like to have a little flexibility. The next thing that I do is trigger. Now, trigger, like I can show you, at this point, on this particular mix, I'm just using it on the kick drum. Now, we have used it for snare drum as well, and now we have the new CLA pack that just came out, so we just picked that up as well. I'm really excited about that. And actually, one of the team members here, Brian Dong, his Dong snare is in that pack, so we're really excited about that. So for just to show you where we're at on the kick drum, let me get to an area here where we actually have kick drum. So the solo out the kick, this is where we're sitting from actual recorded kick drum. And then I'll add the trigger, which really fills it out nice and gives me something clean that I can actually really push up in the mix and actually treat and get the kick where I need it. Our kick drum sound is really good from Ocean. We've put a lot of time into our tone, so we are proud of those. It's not an idea of using trigger to actually replace the sound because of quality. It's more of an enhancing kind of situation than anything. And it just gives you a little bit more flexibility. And in this situation, there's days I'm pushing out 12 mixes a day. So it kind of goes across the board in mix setups, and it's a great starting point. Yeah, so the FGX came into play for us on these mixes about a couple of months ago. And the reason for that was, up until this point, we would mix, and as the record company approved our mixes, we would send them right out to mastering. And we use Universal Mastering to master everything for the voice. And it does become kind of this big assembly line kind of thing. And sometimes we would have more than one mastering engineer mastering our mixes. And the problem was, is we started coming back with masters that all sounded a little bit different. So we were trying to streamline that to try to eliminate that factor in the mastering process. So we've tried a couple of different things. You know, we have buddies using L2 and things like that. And I just wasn't a fan. I think the FGX thing for me just kind of retained what the mix really was. And it wasn't a situation of putting it on the mix after the fact. We would actually mix through it. So that's very important to me because I think the balance changes as you're mixing through something versus actually just putting it in on the back end. So I might treat something a little differently because I'm hearing it actually just, you know, almost as loud as I can get it on the back end. I usually always try to keep, for the most part, I'll keep my levels, and for this song it's kind of a little bit of a ballad, but I'll keep the output at minus 10 or as close to minus 10 as I can get it. Some of the more rocking stuff, if it gets into minus 8, that's fine. And I always feel like at this point, if it gets to mastering and it's a little loud, they can always turn it down. And actually, I've been finding that really the masters have only been coming back like a couple dB louder than what I send them to. So it's actually given them a really good starting point. We're getting ahead of the game from the mastering side of things. One of the things I do, I turn off the compression because I'm running through two external compressors as well. But I will adjust the transients, and a lot of times I'll adjust the low punch or the high detail to just kind of contour into the mix, depending on what it is. If it's a dance thing and it's very hi-hat driven, I'll push the high transient detail part of this up a little bit. So that's working out great for me. And then the only other thing, dynamic perception stays at 0, and then I just adjust the gain to get it to fall somewhere between minus 9, minus 10, somewhere around there. But we're really excited about that, and it doesn't color the mix at all, which is really great for us. In the mix setup, what we'll do before I actually start mixing is we'll reprint the vocal through compression, and we'll get the vocal kind of where we want it from a compression standpoint, and then I'll start mixing from there. So that's always a print back. And at this point, we've been using a couple different compressors for that, depending on what the song is or who the artist is. And recently, we started getting into the Dragon from Slate Products, and we actually really like this compressor. It's been working out great for us, and we're digging into it more and more, and we're finding out that we're really falling in love with it. So we're excited about that. But thanks for stopping by. We're going to get back to work here, and hope to see you around soon. But you